more time.
Good day, students. Welcome again to an exciting educational video. This is Dr. Luisito Masanga at your service. Thank you very much to those students from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao who are faithfully and consistently watching my educational video. A warm round of applause to all of you. Mabuhay! Today, we are going to study about Slovin's formula. What is this? Slovin's formula is used to calculate an appropriate sample size from a population. Slovin's formula was attributed to Michael Slovin, 1960. But there is little information about him. So, Slovin's formula, the sample size is designated as small letter n, while the total population is designated as capital letter N. This is all over this equation. And E represents the margin of error or tolerance error raised to the second power. Of course, we have our learning outcomes. At the end of the tutorial video, students will be able to learn how to compute sample size of the population using Slovin's formula. Number two, understand different confidence level and margin of error or error of tolerance. And number three, practice the application of the formula. Let's discuss first what is target population. The population or target population or universe is where our respondents are located. So, target population or the universe is the totality of possible individuals, items, or cases where data can be obtained. Example, you want to get the perceptions of fourth-year college students in National Capital Region about issues of national development in the Philippines. So, who is the target population? The target population or universe are students in selected colleges, universities in the Philippines. So when we say college universities, this is either private or public or a combination of both. Determining the kind of sample you want to have. Let's understand first the basic units of the population, which is the sampling element. The sampling element in our previous example of fourth-year college students in NCR region, the sampling element is the colleges, universities where students can be found. So, find out what is the appropriate size of the sample, that is how many of the sampling elements are needed as sources of data. So, this is your population. You have to determine your population, target population, for you to compute the small letter n or sample size. So, if you want to compute the sample size for a given target population or universe, we need to use Michael Slovin's formula. Again, the sample size is designated as small letter n, while the population is designated as capital letter N. And the small letter E is designated as margin of error or tolerance of error raised to the second power. Now, before you can solve and compute your sample size, you must determine first your margin of error through your confidence level or level of confidence. All right. So, let's try to discuss about margin of error or tolerance of error. This is the percentage allowable for non-precision since a sample is used instead of a population. So, Slovin's formula is one of the easiest and the most convenient to use in determining the size of the sample. But of course, before identifying or computing the size, the sample size, we have to establish first our margin of error. Let's say we want to have a margin of error of 0.05. What is the confidence level having a margin of error of 5%? The confidence level is equivalent to 95%. Meaning to say, the 95% is you are comfortable and confident that the data, the sample size that you are going to get is representative of the population, meaning to say you are 95% statistically confident. Now, if you want a statistical confidence of 98%, all you have to do is divide this by 100, so that gives you 0.98, and you minus that by 1, which is, you know, 100% minus 0.98 gives you 0.02. See, meaning to say, if you want to use a margin of error of 2%, your confidence level is 98%. If you want to use a margin of error of 5%, your confidence level is 95%. If you want to use a margin of error of 10%, therefore, your confidence level is 90%. That's how you establish your margin of error. Now, after getting the desired sample size, you can now get your sampling frame based on the different discussion that I presented in my tutorial video about probability sampling. You can use a simple random sampling if you already got your sample size, or you could use stratified sample sampling, cluster sampling, or a mix. All right. So, let's try to have an application of the formula. For example, you want to determine a sample size from a population of 1,000 elements, and your margin of error is set at 0.05 or 5% because your confidence level is 95%. Now, using Slovin's formula, we are going to first, the n, the given is 1,000, that's your population. And then your margin of error is 0.05. Okay? So those are the givens. Okay? Now we will substitute the given to the formula. So this one is given. Okay? So, 1 minus 0.95 is 0.05. So, 1,000, that's your capital N. Okay. So, this one, okay. 1 plus 1,000. And then your margin of error is 0.05. How are you going to process this one so that you will not be mistaken when you compute your sample size? First of all, you have to process first your margin of error. 0.05 raised to the second power gives you 0.0025. Okay? And then 1,000 divided by the quantity 1 plus 1,000 times 0.0025. So this one is the second processing. So bring down, okay, So 1000 times 0.0025 gives you 2.5. Quantity 1 plus 2.5 because of this. Now, after processing this one, you have to process this one. So 1000 divided by 1 plus 2.5 gives you 3.5. And 1000 divided by 3.5 gives you 2.85.71. So round it off because there's no such individual with a ratio. So that could be 286. So therefore, from your 1000 population, you need a sample size of 286. So that will be your sample size. So if you want to research on the, let's say for example, if you have a total population of 1000, so you need a sample size of 286. You may want to divide this by 2 in order to have a stratified. You can get male 143 and female is 143. So this is how you are going to apply Slovin's formula in order to get your sample size. So this ends my tutorial video. Thank you very much for listening. Please do subscribe, like, and share the channel. Thank you very much for listening. Always keep safe, everyone. See you later.